Whoa, bunny! Which way? Did he go this way? Salam alaikum. Boys and girls, I was chasing Bunny. I wanted him to come on the show with me. Boys and girls, this is Madrasah TV show, and my name is Ustad Hamza. Today, boys and girls, I'm here to teach you how to read and how to write Quran in a fun way, because Madrasah TV show is a show where we bring Madrasah right in front of your TV screens. Welcome to the show, boys and girls. Hayakumullah. Today, inshallah ta'ala, I'll be teaching you two surahs from Quran. I'll be teaching you Surah Abasa, and I'm also going to teach you, inshallah, Surah Al-Falaq. Boys and girls, I was a bit disappointed. No, not disappointed, a bit sad yesterday. Yesterday, we learned Surah An-Nas, and I thought everyone is going to call. I thought even Bunny is going to call. Bunny didn't call because Bunny have an excuse. You know, Bunny eats too much carrots. He can't recite. But you, all of you can recite Surah An-Nas. Well, I want today, inshallah, all of you to call in and recite Surah Al-Falaq. Not one of you, two of you, everyone, inshallah ta'ala. Now, Surah Abasa, I know some of you can't read it. If you can't read Surah Abasa, why don't you guys do me a favor? Call me in so we can recite it together. Boys and girls, I'm looking at comments on our YouTube channel, and I can literally read all your comments. Let me show you this right now. So, we have a YouTube channel. Maybe you guys didn't know that. 496,000. We're still 4,000 subscribers away from half a million. Now, if I click this, we're live on YouTube, yeah? I can see an ad, which I'm waiting for. And I see another ad. Boys and girls, anyway. We're live on YouTube and Facebook. Every time we go on YouTube, there's an ad. Here we go. So I'm live here, and I can read your comments. I can see Saliha. I can see Khalida, Fatiha. I can read all your comments, mashallah, all your comments, yeah? And it's good to have your comments there so we can interact. Boys and girls, I'm going to be giving you so many quizzes, and I want to find out who answers most of these quizzes correctly, inshallah. So if you want to participate in our quiz segment, make sure you're live on our YouTube. I'm going to take you to the calligraphy class, and I want to show you a beautiful calligraphy. By the way, our new calligrapher is Latifa. Latifa is a calligrapher of today. I want you guys to do me a favor for those of you who are watching me live on YouTube. Hit the share button right underneath the video, and share this, inshallah, on your WhatsApp status. Now, I know you may be probably watching me on TV, or maybe you're watching me on your device or something. Why don't you just go on your phone, huh? Ask permission, yeah? Ask permission. Ask permission. Say, Mom, I want to share this, inshallah, so everyone else can watch this. So I want you to share it, inshallah, on your group. And I want you to hit the share button one more time and share it, inshallah, on your Telegram. I want to tell you guys a secret. Here you go. I shared it on my Telegram group. I also shared it on my WhatsApp group. I'll tell you guys a secret, yeah? You know, if you hit the share button for the third time, you know how much it's going to charge you? It's free. So you can hit the share button third time, and maybe you want to share it somewhere more. Where can I share it? I can even share it on my Facebook. You can share it on your Facebook. You can share it on your Instagram, wherever you like, wherever you can, inshallah ta'ala. Share, share, share. All right? Let's start, inshallah. Let's start. Okay. That was a quick one. Let's start, inshallah. Okay. So I'm looking at this calligraphy. Nazar was the best calligrapher yesterday. I particularly like this calligraphy because yellow is my favorite color. Guys, don't start overusing yellow color. I really like this calligraphy. Nazar has been sending her calligraphy every single day. So every time I teach calligraphy, she practices. I can see some great improvement in her calligraphy. So I gave her, yes, mashallah, she became a calligrapher of today. Today, I'll be teaching you, inshallah ta'ala, verse number 9 from Surah Al-Insan. Are you guys ready? Let me show you the verse. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim.
Inna nakhafu min Rabbina yawman abusan qamtarira.
Allahu Akbar. Inna nakhafu min Rabbina. Subhanallah. Allah Azza wa Jalla is talking very particularly about specific people here in these ayahs. May Allah make me and you among these people. Say Ameen. Say a long one, Ameen. Okay. So we're going to write this ayah together. And maybe we can write the next ayah as well. No. Next ayah can get very long. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ. We stick to, inshallah, one ayah today. Ayah number 10 today, inshallah ta'ala. Ayah number 10. Boys and girls, are you ready? Ayah number 10. Now grab a pen, get a pencil, and let's practice together. Boys and girls, let's practice calligraphy together. I know some of you are used to just sitting down and watching this show like you're watching a comedy show. No. Get a pen, grab a pen, and practice what I teach you, inshallah, today. Yalla, I'm going to show you how to write this this ayah in a nice, beautiful calligraphy. My bad, did I say ayah number 10? Ayah number 9. Yeah? Yalla. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ. Let us start. My first letter is going to be... let's do a quiz. What's the first letter that I'm going to write? I'm saying, فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ شَرَّ ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ. What's going to be my first letter today? فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. Who's going to answer first? Amira Saifuddin, you got a badge. Well done. It's fa. Letter fa. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. And let's write it together, inshallah. Guys, am I going to write left to right or right to left? Who's going to tell me? This is Arabic calligraphy. Am I going to be writing left to right or right to left? Who's going to tell me? Who's going to tell me? Who? Who's going to tell me? Anyone? Anyone? Yes! MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Arabic, right to left. Hold on a second. Did someone say left to right? Left to right. No, that's English. Right to left. Huh? Who's that? Right to left. Farfura, well done. Well done. So if I ask you guys questions, I want you to answer below in the comment box live on YouTube. Huh? Guys, live on YouTube. Yalla, bismillah. Bismillah, bismillah. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. My first letter is going to be fa. A round face. And you bring it a little bit down. Then you go to the left side. Subhanallah. Very easy. Very easy. This is fa. Barakallahu feekum. Now hold on a second. Forgot to put perfume on. I'm writing Quran, so I have to smell nice. Can you guys smell it? It's nice, isn't it? It's like lemon. Oh, you guys can't smell it. Let's continue. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. Next letter is wow. Watch this. Oh, behind my head. Let me go behind the screen. Wa. This is wow. This is wow. Huh? Can you guys see that? Wait. Guys, wait. Watch this. Watch this. And then right at the end, huh? Give it a small twist. There you go. Fawa. You guys telling me it's hard. It's so hard. No. It's so easy. Fa. And then what? You guys finish it? Yalla. 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 Awa, Adnan, Zain, Saliha, Farfura. I want to see everyone's calligraphy. Huh? Farfura, very consistent. Who else? I see Saliha's calligraphy every day. Very nice. Adnan, sometimes, you know? Adnan, sometimes. Huh? I don't know. Sometimes he's busy. Maybe he's doing his shift. Evening shift. So, okay. Have a look at this. Fatiha, I think every day. Yeah, Fatiha every day, mashallah. Amira Saifuddin every day, mashallah. Huh? Jannah. I think some days not. Huh? Yalla. I want to see everyone's calligraphy. Everyone's calligraphy. Barakallahu feekum. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. Next letter, inshallah, is Qaf. Same as these two letters. Barakallahu feekum. There isn't much difference here. So look at this. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. Next letter is Qaf. A round face. Just like fa, a round face. And then there's a bit of a neck. Yeah? And then there is a stretch. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. Next letter, inshallah, is going to be قَوْف. فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ. قَوْف with the alif. But not an actual alif. It's going to be a small alif. So let's leave that for now. Let's leave the small alif for now. We'll deal with the small letters later. Look at this. There is a ha. Alif is going to be here somewhere. So I want you to stretch this, inshallah, enough. So you leave a space for alif. Don't worry about alif right now. And add ha. Watch this, guys. So focus on what I'm doing. I'm going to go all the way up. And then we do this.
فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ
هَا and ميم.
فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ هَا
and then ميم. بارك الله فيكم.
فَوَقَاهُمُ
ميم.
فَوَقَاهُمْ
يلا. Next word inshallah is Allahu, my favorite word.
فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ.
Hold on a second, I see a comment there. Someone is saying, Ustad is writing ayah 11 with lol. Am I?
فَوَقَاهُمُ اللَّهُ.
Oh no. Oh no. Hey Bunny, what did you do? Bunny told me it's ayah number. Oh no, boys and girls. Mistake, my bad. Okay. Let's start all over again, okay? Yeah, it should be inna nakhafu min rabbina. Okay, let's pretend nothing happened and let's start inshallah ta'ala again. My apologies, okay? Let's start. It's Bunny's fault. Let's start the word inna. It's a short ayah anyway. So, you know, guys not going to get tired, promise you. The word is inna. I feel bad. Some of you just started calligraphy for the first ever time in your life and yeah, okay. Don't worry. May Allah reward you for the word that you wrote. You wrote a word from Qur'an, so you're going to get rewarded for it inshallah. Inna nakhafu hamza, noon, and then alif. Inna. I see you guys comments, but sometimes I see them without reading them, yeah? Okay, inna. Next word is nakhafu. Boys and girls, this is very easy. It's a short ayah, so I promise you, for those of you who's saying, Ustad, I wrote an ayah, then you start an ayah again. No. Trust me, it's going to be easy. Kha. Kha. And then we have alif. Nakha. And the last letter here we have is fa. Inna nakhafu. Was that easy? Let me break it down, inshallah. Fa. I'm going to break it down for you guys, yeah? Fa. Round face. And then you go to the left. There we go. This is nakhafu. I'm stretching fa a little bit. I don't want to leave too much gap toward the end. Yalla. Boys and girls. Ha. Inna nakhafu. Mir rabbina. After all, I'm a human being, right? Okay. Inna nakhafu mir rabbina. Someone is asking, what do you do with an ayah if you make a mistake? Do you burn the paper? So here is the thing, guys, yeah? You don't want to write Quran on a paper and then leave it just anyway, yeah? You have to be respectable toward words of Allah. So the best way to deal with it is that you put it somewhere where no one can step on, or, you know, a place that is, how can you say, a respectable place away from people. So I'll give you guys an example. What my parents, or how I used to, I still do, I put Quran on top of the cupboard in my house, or the shelves. So you know we have shelves in the house? Right on top of everything. So nothing is higher or above Quran. Does that make sense? Now if you have a paper and you wanna, you're not reading it, you're not using it, but have words of Allah, what you can do, you can put it somewhere in a garden, maybe dig a little hole, and you can put it there because no one really steps on it, yeah? But if you think that someone might come, maybe an animal will come and step on it or something, that what you can do, inshallah, when you guys do barbecue, you can first of all invite me. Second of all, I'm gonna come. Okay. Third of all, you have to make enough food. Okay. All right. Next, what we're gonna do, we can, inshallah, we can burn it while we are doing the barbecue. Now, when you burn, it's not you're disrespecting words of Allah. It's that you are trying to, in a respectable way, get rid of them without putting it somewhere where maybe someone can step on it or something like that. Boys and girls, if I tell you, and if I be very honest with you, yeah? Someone's saying we missed ayah number 9. Tiban wa asira. Innama nut'imukum liwajhi Allah. Guys, what's happening today? Okay, Salih, I see your comment. Okay, if I tell you guys, yeah, this. When I used to go to school, even the books, even a newspaper, my teachers will tell me, my parents will tell me, don't just throw it on the ground. So if we see any piece of paper that has words written on it, especially Arabic, because I was in Medina and everything was in Arabic, we would say, pick it up. Don't leave it on the floor. Now, these are the same letters that teach you. Whether it's a newspaper, the words that in the newspaper, you see, you may think that these words have no value, but these words teach you, they educate you. So you respect them. The same goes to Quran. Okay. Saliha, thank you very much for pointing out this. We're going to write ayah number 9 tomorrow. Today, let's stay, inshallah, on ayah number 10. Okay, my apologies, guys. We skipped an ayah, but anyway, we'll cover it tomorrow. Inna nakhafu min rabbina. Let's write the word min rabbina, barakallahu feekum. Min. Min rabbina. Meem. Meem. And next letter, inshallah, is noon. Inna nakhafu min. Next word is min rabbina. Min rabbina. Next word is rabbina. Ra, ra, with the small twist. We've got another good question there. So we're live on YouTube and I can see your comments, I can read your comments. Someone is saying, what if we rip it in small pieces and throw it in garbage? I still wouldn't recommend that, especially if these are words of Allah. If there's a book or newspaper or something, yes, you can. If these are words of Allah, you should try to be as considerate as you can, yeah? So what happened if you rip a paper? So let's just say there is something written on a paper. When you rip it, now, yeah, the part that is ripped doesn't really has any meaning to it, right? Of course, then you can. But I would still, if it's Quran, if it's Hadith, if it's an Islamic book, I'll tell you guys something really cool. I wanted to get rid of like 2-3 bags of books, Islamic books, all Qur'ans we had in the masjid. And I was trying to find a solution to it. And this brother, what's his name? Junaid. Brother Junaid, maybe he's watching the show. He told me that there is this place, one of these charities. They take all these books and they take them to far away in countries where people can't afford to buy books, and they give them for free. And I was surprised. I said, really? He said, yeah. I said, so they take these books and... He said, yeah. So I gave him those 3 bags of Islamic books, all Qur'ans, all Qa'idas. There was tons of them. They were all CDs, you know? Guys know CDs? You guys know no CDs? Right. So, you guys just know Wi-Fi, yeah? CDs, cassettes, all of that. I gave it to him. He took it to this charity shop, and they took it. So find something like that. Find something like that online, yeah? Yeah, I did something similar a few weeks ago with this furniture that we had in the house. We were not using it anymore. So we searched online and we found a charity. They will come, take their furniture, and take it to a place where people can use it. Do that, inshallah, instead. Okay? Inna nakhafu min rabbina. Next word is ba. Barakallahu feekum. Min rabbina. Ba. النون إن نخاف من ربنا ب نون and the last letter we have here is ألف إن نخاف من ربنا. Next word يوما. Now I can fit the same word يوما on this line here because it's a short word, it's a small word. So if we have small words, we can fit all of them in one line. Min rab inna nakhafu min rabbina yawman. This is ya. And this is waw. Yaw. And waw, you know, has like a small twist at the end. MashaAllah. Yaw. Next letter, meem. Yawman. Yawman. Meem. With the alif. Min rabbina yawman. Abusan qamtarira. 2 more words, barakallahu feekum. Boys and girls, 2 more words. Min rabbina yawman. After this, inshallah, I have tons of quizzes for you. And I'm also teaching you, inshallah, 2 surahs from Quran. Boys and girls, I'm teaching you, inshallah, ta'ala, Surah Abasa and Surah Al-Ikhlas. Min rabbina yawman. Next word is going to be عبوسًا قمطرير عين 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 عين. Abusan, barakallahu fikum. Ba. Abu. Wow. Abusan. Abu. And then seen fathatain san. Okay, I'll let you guys write three letters here. These three letters. Next letter is an. Abu, sorry, sen. Abu sen. Seen. One. Sen. Seen. Seen. With the alif. Abu sen. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to stretch seen and alif. Abu sen. And I'm going to write the next word on a separate line. Abu sen.
Qamtarira.
Next word is qamtarira. The word is qamtarira. Let's write it together, inshallah. Last word, boys and girls, qaf and meem. Qaf, round face, small neck. Take it to the left side. Oops, this is wrong. You wanna, yep, make sure it doesn't touch the face here, yeah? Qaf. And the next letter, inshallah, is meem. Qam. And the following letter is ta. Qam ta. 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 Qam ta. Ri ra ra. With the ya. Qam ta ri ra. There is a ya. And there is a. Ra with the alif, barakallahu fikum. Qamtari ra ra. And the last letter here we have alif. Qamtari ra. Big word, massive word. Abusan qamtari ra. This is ayah number 10. I am aware, boys and girls. I'm aware, we skipped one ayah. We're going to come back to the ayah tomorrow, yeah? Okay. All right, boys and girls. Now, it would be wrong if I were to write ayah number 10 and then 9. Yeah? If I were to do that in order, that's a bit out of order, and that would be wrong. But if I were to write ayah number separately and then ayah number 9 separately, then it's fine. Boys and girls, I've got tons of quizzes for you. I want to know who's ready. If you're ready, give me a big ready in the comment. Ready. Muskan, right? Salaam alaikum. I can see your name written in Hindi language. That's how it looks like. Okay. Are we ready, boys and girls? Yalla, Bismillah. My first question here. This word here is in. Okay. There is one letter here that's supposed to have a dot. Which letter is it going to be? Hamza, Noon, Alif. Which one? Easy question. What letter is there that if you see it, if you see it, you would see a dot on top and you would know it's the letter Noon, Adnan. Well done, Adnan answered first. Well done, Adnan. Huh? Noon has a dot on top. There we go. Inna. Next word, Barakallahu Feekum. I'm going to ask a similar quiz, but listen to me. There are four letters in this word. Noon, kha, alif, fa. How many dots do we add to fa? How many? Does anyone know? How many dots do we add to fa? One or two? Here we go. We got an answer there. Someone is saying two. I'm a bit sad. If I were to add two dots on top of fa, it becomes qaf. Boys and girls, the correct answer is one. And Muskan answered it first. Well done, Muskan. One dot on top of fa. One dot on top of fa. Boys and girls, there's only one dot on top of fa. One dot. Similarly, we just add a single dot on top of noon. And how many dots do we add to kha? How many? One or two or three? We add one dot to kha. Muskan got a badge, and now Amira, Chair Amira. Who was it? Habil. Am I right? That's, you said you're using your mom's account. Is that Habil? Okay, well done, Habil. Inna nakhafu. One dot, guys. Guys, easy. Easy quizzes, yeah? All right. I'm going to make the quizzes a bit hard right now. If I say to you, how many dots do we add to noon? Now, we all know that. It's one dot. So I'm not going to ask this question. But I'm going to go to next word here. I'm going to go to this word here. Rabbina. Can someone tell me what's the difference between ba and noon here? What's the difference? Because they both look very, very, very similar, boys and girls. There is one difference between ba and noon. Does anyone know what's the difference between ba and noon? Let's see. Let's say you're walking down the road and you see ba and noon. They would look exactly the same. I'm telling you this right now. I've met noon several times. Huh? Yeah, what's the difference? Top and the bottom, huh? The dot is under ba and the dot is on top of noon. Farfara, I like the answer, huh? A quick one, but with a nice explanation. Okay. Okay, I see all the rest of the answer, guys. Barakallahu feekum. Ba has a dot underneath, noon has a dot on top. Keep that in mind. The word is Rabbina. And this word here is Yawman. Ya. Hold on. How many dots do we add to Ya? One, two, three, four. How many? How many dots are we adding to Ya? One, two, three, four. How many? The answer is two. Muskan takes the lead. Well done, Muskan. Ikram and Afia. Afia, huh? Is rising, boys and girls. A short break. When we come back, we will continue, inshallah ta'ala, with loads of other quizzes. I wanted the guys to give me a call if you're ready to recite, because we're going to start our recitation segment, inshallah ta'ala, straight after the break. Stay with us. Come back after the break so we can continue. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum, boys and girls. Welcome back to Madrasah TV show. Just talking during the break to someone. Got some exciting things coming. Not allowed to speak about it. Boys and girls, there's a surprise. I'm not allowed to speak about it. So let's go back to the lesson. Okay, so, مِن رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا. So we're learning that, you know, subhanAllah, dots. Sometimes, dots. The dots. This is noon. And this is ba. Put it back up. Add another one. This is ta. And this is ya. Put it back up. One more on top. This is tha. Bring it down. This is pe. Wrong language. Okay. In Arabic. Okay. We don't have three dots underneath. You guys following? So dots. 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 These letters look exactly the same when we join them. The only difference is what? The dots, barakallahu feekum. So focus with me. Yawman. This word is abusan. Listen to me. Abusan. There's only one letter here that's supposed to have a dot. But tell me, how many dots do we add to seen? I tricked some of you now. I know. You guys are going to get tricked. How many dots do we add to seen? Abusan. Adnan got tricked. Saleh got tricked. Ikram got tricked. Ikram with his brother Abdul Wahid, both with his, they all got tricked. Okay, all right. Amira, well done. Amira Saifuddin, well done. Guys, no dots on top of scene. No dots. Okay, all right. Listen to me. Okay. So the only letter that's supposed to have a dot here is ba. What happens if I add a dot on top of ayn? What happens if I add a dot on top of ayn? Will it change the weather? What will happen? Abusan. Will ayn get upset? It becomes gain. Gain or ghain? Okay. I know you guys are trying to spell it, yeah? Okay. All right. Muskan, well done. It becomes ghain, yeah? Abusan. I saw this somewhere, yeah, on the internet. It's not funny, yeah? So, have a look at this, guys, yeah? So, look, if I see a joke, I don't find it funny, I'm just going to say it's not funny. Sorry, guys, yeah? So, somewhere, it's written something like this. No pain, no, and then letter ghoin. Letter ghoin. Now, no, please, don't do that. No ghoin. No pain, no ghoin. No, bad joke. This is a bad joke. Doesn't fit. I'll tell you guys another one. If you want to be healthy, you must go to, and then people put this letter here. Go to gym. In which accent, you say, I'm going to gym? No one says that. So bad joke. I'm sorry. For everyone who posted this, you have to go delete that post. Archive it. If you don't like deleting it. You guys would... don't do that, guys. This is jim. If you want to write jim using Arabic letters, okay, fair enough. You want to make people laugh. Okay, that's fine. Put jim kasra, mim sukun, jim. There we go. Go to jim. Jim. Now you're going to say, oh, Ustad, but people don't understand this. Khalas, if they don't understand Arabic, they can find some English jokes. If you're going to use Arabic letters, use the right ones. Okay, let's go back, inshallah. Let's go back. Okay. Abusan, qamtarira. Okay. There are two letters here that are supposed to have dots in this word, qamtarira. Which ones? Which letters are we talking about? Qamtarira. Boys and girls, which letters are we talking about? Qaf, mim, ta, ra, ya, ra, alif. Which one's supposed to have dot? Qamtarira. Yes. Qamtarira. Haha. Okay. Qaf and ya. MashaAllah. Tabarakallah. Okay. I see Muskan and Saliha both get badges. Well done, Muskan and Saliha. Huh? Two dots on top, two dots underneath. Yeah, mashallah. Let's go back up here. And I can hear the phones ringing. Boys and girls, if you want to recite with me, or if you want to recite on the show, everyone who recites today on the show is going to earn a badge. Bunny is going to give a badge to everyone who calls in and recites. Boys and girls, call me in on the number below if you're ready to recite. We're reciting two surahs today, Surah Abasa and Surah Al-Falaq. I know a lot of you can recite Surah Al-Falaq, so call me in. Yalla. Inna nakhafu. The word is inna. Boys and girls, this word here is inna. Hamza kasra. E. Inna. The word is what? Inna. Hamza kasra. Noon shadda. In. In. Noon fatha na. Inna. Okay. All right. Is this word inna or inna? First, inna. Second, inna. Which one is correct? First one or the second one? Look at the word again. Inna. Or is it inna? First one or second one? Huh? Okay. Afia, well done. Huh? Your answer came too fast. Yeah? It is inna. Inna. Sometimes you would see this word with the round circle on top of alif. Then you read it as inna. Yes, following? Barakallahu feekum. This word here is na khafu. Noon fatha na, kha fatha alif sukun kha, na kha fa dhamma fu. All together, na khafu. Next word is min. This word here is min. What should I add to meme to make it sound me? How can we make meme sound like me? What do we add? Inna nakhafu min. Muskan saying kasra. Afia saying kasra. Farfura saying kasra. Well done to all of you. Well done, guys. We add a kasra to meme. Min. Next word here is rabbina. So it is mir rabbina. Ra with the shadda. And a fatha. Ba with the kasra, noon with the fatha, with alif, na. My question here is, what's the stretching letter in this word? The word is rabbina. Ma huwa harful mad? What's the stretching letter here, boys and girls? Mir rabbina. Mir rabbina. I like this username, slave to Allah. Someone is saying I'm new. Welcome, welcome. Okay, Rabbina. The stretching letter here is Alif. Afia Zainab. I'll give the badge to Zainab. If that's okay, Afia, yeah? If that's not okay, you can. Half for you, half for your sister. Rabbina. Next word is Yawman. Ya Fatha. Waw Sukun. Yaw. Meem Fathatain. Man. Yawman. The word is Yawman. Yawman. Abusan. Oh, who added a dot here? There are no dots on top of Ayn, boys and girls. Abusan. Ayn fatha a. Ba dhamma waw sukun. Bu. What should I add to seen to make it sound like sen? Should I add a noon? Makes sense, isn't it? Sen. Add a noon to make it like sen. No. Mir rabbina. Mir Rabbina. Thank you very much. Salih Mutlib. Get a silver badge for pointing out a mistake. Mir Rabbina. There's a shadda on top of ba. Boys and girls, there's a shadda on ra and ba. Rabbina. Well done, Salih. What should we do? Fatha tain. Farfura. Very nice. Add two fathas on top of seen to make it sound sen. Abu sen. Abu sen. Last word is qamtariran, barakallahu feekum. Qaf fatha mim sukun qam. Ta fatha ta qamta. Ra kasra ya sukun ri. And the last letter is ra with fathatain ran. All together qamtariran. May Allah bless all of you. Boys and girls, let's have a look at the ayah that we practice today. We practice ayah number 10 from Surah Al-Insan. Inna nakhafu min Rabbina. يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا. By mistake, we skipped an ayah, which we are going to cover tomorrow. Boys and girls, it's time for you to finish off the calligraphy. Add some nice design or things around it. Make sure your name is nice and clear. Guys, make sure your name is slightly far away from the writing, maybe somewhere in the corner. Don't mix it up with the writing. And send it to me on the WhatsApp number below. Take a picture, send it to me. And I'm going to take you, inshallah ta'ala, to our Qur'an segment, boys and girls, where I'm going to teach you, inshallah ta'ala, Surah Abasa and Surah Al-Falaq. Are you guys ready?
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Actually, I should start with isti'adha.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Today we're starting from قتل الإنسان, ayah number 17.
قتل الإنسان ما أكفره من أي شيء خلقه من نطفة خلقه فقدره ثم السبيل يسره ثم أماته فأقبره ثم إذا شاء أنشره كلا لم يقضي ما أمره فلينظر الإنسان إلى طعامه أنا صببنا الماء صبا ثم شققنا الأرض شقا فأنبتنا فيها حبا وعنبا وقضبا وزيتونا ونخلا وحدائق غلبا وفاكهة وأبا متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم.
617 to 32, boys and girls, from ayah number 17 to 32 from Surah Abasa. Now, these ayahs are particularly very easy. They're easy to teach, they're easy to recite, because these are short verses. This surah is full of short verses. Now, Surah Al-Falaq, we'd like to focus, you guys focus on Surah Al-Falaq.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات فاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد.
Now you see everything I've highlighted in red. Yeah, everything I highlighted in red. فلاق فلاق وقاب عقد. These are the bouncing letters. What else? Let me take the first recital. السلام عليكم Rahima, first caller. Assalamu alaikum, Rahima.
Alaikum salam.
Welcome to the show, Rahima. How are you today?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah.
Rahima, you sound ready. You're the first caller of the day. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready, inshallah.
Rahima, just focus on your kasra letters, yeah? When you say a letter with the kasra, for example, qutila, bismillah, give me a big smile, okay?
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قتل الإنسان الإنسان ما أكفره من أي شيء خلقه من نطفة خلقه فقدره ثم السبيل يسره ثم أماته فأقبره ثم إذا شاء أنشره لا لم يقض ما أمره لينظر الإنسان إلى طعامه إنا صببنا الماء صبا ثم شققنا الأرض شقا أنبتنا فيها حبا عنبا وقضبا زيتونا ونخلا حدائق غلبا فاكهة أبا متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم عباد.
Up to here, Surah Al-Falaq.
بالله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد.
Rahima, with me. Say with me, sherry. Sherry. One more time, sherry. Now, let's try this one. A'udhu billahi.
A'udhu billahi.
Ha, B, change it to B. Billahi.
Billahi.
Inshallah, tabarak. The voice is cutting off, but very good. Huh? Guys, I like it. If you call in, give it a try, even if you make mistakes. Huh? If you don't try, you don't gain. If you don't try, you don't gain anything. Yeah? Yalla. Yalla, boys and girls, let's take the next call. MashaAllah. Well done, Rahima. Assalamu alaikum, Abdul Razak. Welcome to the show. How are you, Abdul Razak?
Alhamdulillah. And how are you?
I'm very well, Alhamdulillah. Yesterday my throat was a bit, but Alhamdulillah. You ready?
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قتل الإنسان ما أكفره من أي شيء خلقه من نطفة خلقه فقدره ثم السبيل يسره ثم أماته فأقبره ثم إذا شاء أنشره كلا لما يقض ما أمره فلينظر الإنسان إلى طعامه إنا صببنا الماء صبا شققنا الأرض شقا فأنبتنا فيها حبا وعنبا وقضبا وزيتون ونخلا حدائق غلبا وفاكهة وأبا متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم.
ما شاء الله سورة الفلق.
اوكي ان شاء الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل اعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق اذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد.
Okay. عقد عقد دال as an empty mouth letter. Very good. Very 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 nice. May Allah bless you, عبد الرزاق. We go to our next caller. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة وبركاته.
Khalila, where are you calling us from?
Dublin.
Khalila, make sure you're not on a loudspeaker. Just put phone right next to your ear. And tell me, are you reciting both surahs today?
Yes, inshallah, but I do not know Surah Al-Abasa.
Okay, that's fine. Let me hear Surah Al-Ikhlas from you, then I can teach you Surah Al-Abasa.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد
لم يلد ولم يولد سورة الفلق
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد.
ما شاء الله تبارك الله. ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. خليلة, I'm gonna teach you سورة عبسة إن شاء الله تعالى. You still there?
Yes.
Let's read together. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
قتل الإنسان.
قتل الإنسان.
ما أكفره.
ما أكفره.
من أي
من ليل
شيء
شيء
خلق
خلق
من نطفة
من نطفة
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 خلقه
خلقه
فقدره
فقدره ثم
سبيل
سبيل
يسره ثم أماته
فأقبره
ثم إذا
شاء
أنشره
أنشره ترى.
كلا.
بل لا.
لما يقضي.
يقضي.
ما أمر.
قرر.
فلينظر.
فلينظر.
إنسان.
إنسان.
إلى.
إلى.
طعام.
أن
صببنا ال
صببنا ال
ماء
ماء
صب
صب
ثم
شققنا
الأرض شقا
شقا.
Khalila, well done. Boys and girls, we're going to take a short break, come back, and we're going to hear more and more and a lot of recitations. Come back after the break so we can listen to your recitation as well. I'll see you guys then. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back, boys and girls, to Madrasah TV show. Muhammad is next. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. How are you, Ustaz?
Very well, Muhammad. How are you today?
I am fine, alhamdulillah.
حياك الله. Let's hear your recitation.
Okay, inshallah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. كلا لما يقض ما أمره فلينظر الإنسان إلى طعامه أنا صببنا الماء صبا ثم شققنا الأرض شقا فأنبتنا فيها حبا وعنبا وقضبا وزيتونا ونخلا وحدائق غلبا وفاكهة وأبا متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد.
أحسنت يا محمد. بارك الله فيك. Extraordinary bad. Habil is the next reciter. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, Ustaz Hamza?
I'm very well, Habil. How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
Habil, are you ready?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Can I read certain Falaq?
Go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد.
ما شاء الله. Habil, say with me one more time. فلاق
فلاق
خلاق
خلاق
وقاب
وقاب.
There we go. Bouncing letters, Habil. You did very well. May Allah bless you. And let's take the next caller. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
And who's calling?
Asma.
Asma, welcome to the show. Are you reading both surahs?
No, I'm reading Surah Al-Falaq.
Go ahead, Asma.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر حاسد إذا وقب ومن ش... شر حاسد إذا حسد.
Oops, we skipped an ayah. Let's try one more time. وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ
وَمِن شَرِّ عَاسِقٍ
غَاسِقٍ. Say that one more time with me. غَاسِقٍ
غَاسِقٍ.
Now, after this ayah, there is another ayah. وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ
وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ
فِي الْعُقَدَ
فِي الْعُقَدَ.
You want to give it another go? Read it one more time.
Okay. أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو أمين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق وَمِن شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبَ وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ.
وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ
وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدَ.
Not bad.
اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ.
ما شاء الله. غَاسِقٍ غَيْن غَاسِقٍ. Let's go to the next call. Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. Ikram.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to the show, Ikram. How are you today?
I am fine, alhamdulillah. How are you?
Very well, alhamdulillah. Is Abdul Wahid and Hafsa reciting as well?
Yes.
Okay, let's start with you.
Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قتل الإنسان ما أكثره من أي شيء خلقه من نطفة خلقه فقدره ثم السبيل يسره ثم أماته فأقبره ثم إذا شاء أنشره كلا لما يقض ما أمره فلينظر الإنسان إلى طعامه أنا صببنا الماء صبا ثم شققنا الأرض شقا فأنبتنا فيها حبا وعنبا وقضبا وزيتونا ونخلا وهدائك غلبا وفاكهة وأبا متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. صدق الله العظيم.
حاء أن حاء أن حاء Hasad, no, hasad. You did very well, Ikram. May Allah bless you. I want to listen to Abdul Wahid, his brother. Her brother. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to the show. Abdul Wahid, you ready?
Yes.
Go ahead.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
سورة الفلق عبد الواحد سورة الفلق أن
ومن شر غاسق
عبد الواحد okay we couldn't hear you عبد الواحد Let's start again.
What?
Let's start Surah Al-Falaq one more time.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq. من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد صدق الله العظيم
Not bad. Let me hear Surah Abasa from you. If you can recite that, Abdul Wahid.
Okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Kutilal insanu ma akthara min ayyi shay'in khalaqah. Min nutfatin khalaqah. خلقه فقدره ثم السبيل يسره ثم ماته فقبره ثم إذا شاء أنشره كلا لما يقض ما أمره فلينظر الإنسان إلى طعامه أنا سببنا الماء صبا ثم شققنا الأرض شقا فأنبتنا فيها حبا وعنبا وقضبا وزيتونا ونخلا وحدائق غلبا وفاكهة وعبا متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم صدق الله العظيم
ما شاء الله تبارك الله Let's go to Hafsa boys and girls السلام عليكم حفصة
عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته How are you, Ustaz?
I'm very well. Hafsa, how are you?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah.
Go ahead, Hafsa. Let's start from Surah Abasa.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Qutila al-insanu ma من أي شيء خلقه من نطفة خلقه فقدره ثم السبيل يسره ثم أماته فأقبره ثم إذا شاء أنشره كلا لما يقض ما أمره فلينظر الإنسان إلى طعامه أنا صببنا الماء صبا ثم شققنا الأرض شقا فانبتنا فيها هبا وعنبا وقضبا وزيتونا ونخلا وحدائق غلبا وفاكهة وابا متاعا لكم ولأنعامكم.
ما شاء الله. سورة الفلق.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد.
صدق الله العظيم. Not bad. The recitation is a bit too fast, but Hafsa, may Allah bless you. So how about we recite one surah next time, Hafsa, but slowly. You did well. Next call, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Welcome to the show. Is this Aniha?
No.
Adnan. Adnan, welcome. Adnan, let me hear Surah Al-Falaq from you. Ready?
I'm ready, and Amir is reciting after me.
Go ahead.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. قل أعوذ برب الناس. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات فاسات في الوقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
ما شاء الله تبارك الله. علي عين عين يا نقع. Let me listen to the sibling. السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام.
And what's your name?
I'm Amira.
Amira, let me hear Surah Al-Falaq from you.
Okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq. من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. صدق الله العظيم.
Extraordinary. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless you. Jasmine would be our final reciter. Assalamu alaikum, Jasmine.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam. Welcome to the show, Jasmine. How are you today?
Good, alhamdulillah. How are you?
Alhamdulillah, Jasmine. Give me nice recitation. Go ahead.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytan. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا حسد.
ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب
ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن ومن شر
شر النفاثات
كالعقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد.
MashaAllah, Tabarakallah, boys and girls, let's have a look at some of the calligraphies. And well done for trying, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. We have a cooler, but I'm going to say apologize because we got so many calligraphies that I want to go over. Boys and girls, let's have a look at the calligraphies. Hanifa, call us tomorrow early, inshallah. Okay, let's have a look at this calligraphy here. Fatima. Fatima, 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 MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. I would say Fatima, that this one here won't be needed because you wrote your name already. Abus and Qamtarira, you know what? This is a nice, beautiful design, mashallah. Fatima, beautiful design. Calligraphy can improve. Can improve a lot. Group your letters together. Yeah? Each word has letters, so put them together close to each other. MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. Beautiful one, Fatima. Have a look at this, boys and girls. Ooh, this is by Naza, 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 mashallah, tabarakallah. What a beautiful one. Naza. I'm going to say this one deserves a silver badge. Very, very nice. I would say this gap here, you see this gap here is a... makes it look not too nice. Yeah? Okay. Moving on to next one. And this is by Farzana. MashaAllah, tabarakallah, Farzana. Good work. I like the fact that all the letters are, all the words are in the box, and the box looks quite full. Number 10 here is inside a circle, but I can hardly see the circle. So maybe you want to use a green color or something next time, yeah? Aminata, mashallah, tabarakallah, Aminata, very nice. Abusan qamtarira. Something happened here, yeah? Abusan, this is one word, so try to put them together. Try to put all of them together in one go. All together as a word. Latifa, mashallah, tabarakallah. Amazing, Latifa. Latifa, beautiful. Wala shukura. This is ayah number 9. Beautiful one. Mashallah, tabarakallah. Ooh, boys and girls, this is saliha. Inna nakhafu min rabbina yawman abus. Beautiful. I would suggest, saliha, that you stretch this scene all the way. See this empty space here? Too empty. We want to fill it up a little bit with something. This is too empty. Too empty. Saliha, well done. So stretch the scene a little bit. Safra, mashallah, tabarakallah, safra. Safra. There is a bit of issue that happened here. Although this looks beautiful, you're writing with the pink or red color, and the background is also pink and red. You see what's happening there? The word Ar-Rahim, Ha and Ya, Mim completely disappeared. So maybe next time, I could see green color here much more clearly than the red one. MashaAllah, amazing work, Safra, though. Maybe you want to use different color next time, yeah? Muhammad Thabit, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah, Alayk, Ya Muhammad. Gold badge, Ya Muhammad. Very nice, very nice, Ya Muhammad. Very nice. Ismail, you can see a fish here. Nice, Ismail. Very, very, inna nakhafu min rabbina. Now, Ismail, you see this line that you're putting these letters on. Maybe you want to draw that line with the lighter color. Yeah, maybe. Other than that, mashallah, it is absolutely beautiful. Let's have a look at next one. Fatiha! MashaAllah, tabarakallah, ya Fatiha. Very, very, very nice. I see too much gap between za and alif. Looks like jaza and separate letters, yeah? Here, too much gap between qamtari, ira, too much gap between them. It makes it look like as if they're separate words, but mashallah, mashallah. Imran, inna nut'imukum liwajhillahi la nuridu minkum, mashallah, tabarakallah, Imran, absolutely beautiful. Asma, very, very nice. But all your letters are above the line. Remember we talked about this, ra should be lower, especially ra. And wow as well. But Asma, this is absolutely beautiful. And let's have a look at last few. Farfura. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Very neat and clean, mashallah. Very, very nice. Ah. Here we have a Zainab. Mashallah, tabarakallah, Zainab. It looks simple, but it looks really pretty. These two dots, move them away from Ra, yeah? Okay, we don't want dots to touch anything. Here we have a Zaid, mashallah, alayk ya Zaid. Keep it up, ya Zaid. And last one is Samiha Rahman. Beautiful Samiha Rahman. I like it. She's trying to fit everything in a circle. Boys and girls, who's the calligrapher and who is the reciter of today? We're going to find that out, inshallah ta'ala, right now. Tomorrow, we're going to be live again at 4 p.m. Tune in if you want to learn, inshallah ta'ala, more. Boys and girls, let's have a look. Let's have a look at our reciter of the day. And it is Adnan, mashallah, tabarakallah alayk. Boys and girls, let's find out, inshallah ta'ala, real quick, who's the calligrapher of today? It is the one and only Imran. Boys and girls, tune in tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala, at 4 p.m. so you can learn more. Tomorrow we'll be learning the last part of Surah Abasa and Surah Al-Ikhlas. Also, if you're watching me on YouTube or Facebook, make sure you share, leave some nice comments, and subscribe and follow. And I'll be seeing you tomorrow at 4 p.m. Until then, boys and girls, with lots of du'as, may Allah bless you all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.